logged into your Chromebook. You want to go to fillasd.org, choose login, it brings you to this screen, and you just type in your student ID. And your password. Your password is going to show up as dots, which is great because I don't want you logging in as a student. You press login. And it will bring you to Message Center. And that, and Message Center will bring up your icon. So here you can get into your Achieve 3000, your Lexia if you're a younger student, your iReady's in here for your math, Smarty Ants for younger learners' literacy. Down further, you will have your Google Classroom. If you click here, it's going to bring up your classes, right? Oh, it's logged in as me and not that student I have a few accounts on. But I have another video on navigating Google Classroom, which will be your next video to watch. All right, so here are your Google Classrooms. I'm going to show how we turn in work. I've already done the video on how to find the stream and the classwork, etc. But I want to show you how you turn in work when you have it. So here's our stream, announcements, etc. I'm going to go to classwork. I'm going to go to an old assignment from the week before. So I'm going to go to the Wacky Webtail. And there's a presentation for the student to watch here, and it will link that student to the assignment they have to do. But I'm going to just do a fake webtail here for this student. Again, I'm not going to count this as the student's work. This is just me showing you. So you see we're in the assignment for this young man. We would put our name under name. Name, right? And the homeroom was, I think, a fourth grade room. And then down here, I would input my information, or I would paste in the webtail if I was doing this real assignment. Right? This is just to show you how we turn stuff in. So down below, the student would have all their work. Blah, 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 all their assignment, all the information's here. Let's pretend this is a good assignment with this student's name, their homeroom, their story. They like the way it looks. They think they're done. They're going to hit turn in right here. That will send it back to me as the teacher that assigned it, or back to your homeroom teacher if you're doing an assignment. If you actually turned in something with just gibberish and without your real name, the teacher can return it to you and you can edit it again. The teacher may also comment on it. You may see a comment when they send it back telling you what you need to change. All right. If there was a comment, you could comment back and mark it as resolved. So if the teacher wrote back and said, hey student, you just typed gibberish here, the student could delete that, type in a real story, go to the comment section and say, okay, it's resolved, mark it as resolved, or say, okay, I made my changes, and turn it back in. Remember, anything that you comment, we will see, so be appropriate. Don't type anything silly or worse, and make sure you're turning in your work. Don't just turn in blank assignments. A lot of students do that. They click the link, they hit turn in, and think they're done. No, you actually have to do the work, then turn it in. So please do the work. If you have questions, message your teachers on Dojo. Comment on the assignment. All right, so another way you may be required to turn work in. If we go to our classwork tab, and you have an assignment and there's not something really to turn in, if you view the assignment, I'm just gonna use a technology one. This doesn't ask for you to add a comment, but if a teacher does say, add a comment or something, you could say it was done, or you could say if you had trouble with a comment. You could add a comment here. Right? And ask for help. I'm not going to do that because I'm in a student account. But the other thing you could do is add or create, like if your teacher needs a picture, you can add or create here, and you can add a slideshow, a drawing, a link. You could take a photo or add an attachment, right? If you had a picture, and send that in as completed work if need be. And here's your little send button when you're done. So that is yet another way to turn in work if the teacher asks for it in your commands. If you're unsure, you could always add a comment and say, do you need a picture or should I send something? Or send it if you want. We always love to see what you guys are making at home.